Hello everyone. In the previous session, I have discussed about Bernoulli's equation being applied to the ideal and real fluid flow. We have also seen the numericals based on this equation. In this session, we will discuss about the practical applications of Bernoulli's equation, in which the first one I am taking is Venturimeter. It is a device used for measuring the rate of flow of fluid flowing through a pipe. Next, we will see the derivation for the rate of flow through the Venturimeter. Here you can see a diagram of a Venturimeter. This is the inlet of the pipe and this is the outlet of the pipe. Here is your Venturimeter in between. The first portion is called as a short converging section or end. The middle portion is called as a throat. And the long end over here which you see is called as a diverging section or diverging end. A U-tube manometer is fitted between the two sections over here. The two sections are marked with the pressure tap. Now, here you can see that the fluid which is flowing through the Venturimeter is water. That is what I have assumed. The diameter over here is D1. The pressure is P1. Velocity is V1. At this section, the diameter will be D2. Velocity will be V2. And pressure will be P2. If you apply Bernoulli's equation between the sections 1 and 2, the equation will be P1 upon rho g plus V1 square upon 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square upon 2g plus Z2. We have already seen this equation in the previous sessions. Now, since the pipe which we are taking is horizontal, therefore I will consider Z1 is equal to Z2. They both get cancelled out from both the ends. So, what remains is P1 upon rho g plus V1 square upon 2g is equal to P2 upon rho g plus V2 square upon 2g. Or I can say P1 minus P2 upon rho g is equal to V2 square minus V1 square upon 2g. Here I have taken the pressure and velocity terms on the same side. The difference of pressure head at the section 1 and 2 can be written as P1 minus P2 upon rho g. So this h can also be substituted here and you can get V2 square upon 2g minus V1 square upon 2g. I mark this as equation 1. We know from continuity equation, which is applied between section 1 and 2, I can say A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Therefore, I can say V1 is equal to A2 V2 upon A1. I mark this as equation 2. Let's substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Then we get H is equal to V2 square upon 2G minus V1 will be substituted as A2 V2 upon A1, the whole square upon 2G. I multiply this 2g term over here because it is common to both. It's a common denominator. What remains over here is v2 square minus a2 square v2 square upon a1 square. v2 square is common in both, so I take it as a common term. And what remains is 1 minus a2 square upon a1 square on the right hand side. And the left hand side still remains the same. 2gh is equal to v2 square into a1 square minus a2 square upon a1 square. I take V2 square on one side and rest of the terms on the other side. I want to calculate V2, so I just take the square on the other end and it becomes a root sign. I mark it as equation 3. We know Q is equal to A2 V2, so I can substitute V2 in this equation. So my Q theoretical can be written as A1 A2 root of 2GH upon root of A1 square minus A2 square, where A1 and A2 is the area of section 1 and 2. Now, this equation 5, which I have marked over here, is the theoretical discharge through the Venturimeter under ideal conditions. But in real conditions, you will always find some losses because of friction. So, I can say that Q actual is equal to CD A1 A2 root of 2GH divided by root of A1 square minus A2 square, where CD is called as the coefficient of discharge. The range of CD for Venturimeter is generally 0.97 to 0.99. So the CD can be calculated over here as Q actual divided by this term is actually Q theoretical. So I can say CD is Q actual upon Q theoretical. This value will be less than 1, as you can see that Q actual is always less as compared to Q theoretical. So this is all about the derivation of flow through the Venturimeter. This formula can be used for calculating the actual discharge. In case you want to calculate the theoretical discharge, you can use this formula. In the next class, we will see some numericals based on this concept. Thank you.